Now we'll see some problems related to this, you know, mapping techniques to understand them clearly. Okay, so first we see this problem. How many total bits are required for a direct mapped cache? So this is important. It's a direct mapped cache with 16 KB of data and 4 word blocks, assuming a 32 bit address. Okay, so address size is 32 bit and, you know, cache size is 16 KB. Whenever they say that cache size is 16 KB, especially they clearly mentioned that it is 16 KB of data. So that means, so the other bits we should not consider. That means tag bits we should not consider in this 16 KB, and that valid bit we should not consider. Okay. Now we will see the more details about this problem. First thing, the question is about how many total bits are required. You know, data bits are given 16 KB, but how many total bits are required for a cache is the question. So in a cache, what are the things we will be having if the mapping technique is direct? So for every block, you will be having a tag, right? That means number of tag bits are required to find out the size of the cache. Apart from that, I told you that there will be a valid bit. I am assuming that, let's say, so valid bit also to be counted. Sometimes, you know, in the question they will clearly mention what are the bits present in the cache. Okay, now I am assuming for this problem, okay, this is not a gate problem, that's why it is not completely clear, but in the gate exam they will mention what is the structure of the cache. That means what are the fields we have in cache. Okay, so I am assuming in this problem valid bit, tag and data. Okay, so this is assumption. For this, you know, assumption we are solving the problem. Okay, now don't question this assumption. Don't ask me, sir, why valid bit? Okay, so in the question it is not given, right? But, you know, I am assuming that, let's say, valid bit is there and I'm solving it. But in the gate exam they will clearly mention whether to take valid bit or not, whether tags to be taken or not, everything. Okay, now for this problem I'm solving. The question is how many total bits are required for a complete cache. Now assume that, let's say, you have one block, there are lot of blocks, but for this particular block, then how many bits are required, how many bits you are storing in this block? Valid bit, one bit, right? Number of tag bits, that means we have to calculate number of tag bits. And what is the size of the data in this block? Did they give anything? No, the total cache size is given 16 KB, right? And each cache block size 4 words, we should remember. Okay, now sir, our system is byte addressable, otherwise word addressable. Which one we have to take, sir, in the question? If nothing is mentioned, go for word addressable system. Okay, otherwise they will mention that system is byte addressable. In the problem nothing is mentioned, right? Then I am going to solve this problem with two cases. One is byte addressable system, second one word addressable. Let us begin with word addressable system, which is easy to, you know, answer. First, word addressable system. In word addressable system, what happens? Every word gets one memory address, remember it. Okay, now here interesting thing is we have to find out the division, like, you know, how many bits are required for word offset. If it is really word addressable system, then your main memory address is divided into three parts. Okay, I'll show that. So your main memory address we are going to divide logically into three parts. One is for these bits for word offset, okay, to identify which word. Now remaining memory address will be divided into two parts, we know that, because it's a direct map technique. Then we have to divide that into two parts. One is cache offset, otherwise cache index bits, then tag bits. So how to find out each and everything, we will see. From now onwards, whenever you have a direct map problem, divide the main memory address into three parts. Okay, so the first part is word offset. The remaining part is nothing but block number, main memory block number. That is further divided into two parts, tag and cache index. Okay, this cache index depends on the number of cache blocks. Okay, word offset depends on the number of words in the block. Now we begin with this one, four word blocks. That means each cache block has four words: word 1, word 2, word 3, word 4. Since our system is word addressable system, then how many bits are required to differentiate them? Two bits are required, right? In the main memory address, two bits we can dedicate for word offset. Based on that, appropriate word can be selected. So 00011011, you understand that point, right? So finally we got word offset as two bits, right? Now, cash index. This cash index, you know, depends on the number of cash blocks. That's why we have to compute number of cash blocks. So what is the information we have? We have total cash size 16 KB, right? So this 16 KB is specially only the data part. So we will be then in each block, how many words we are writing? 4 words. Okay, remember it, 4 words. So in this problem, generally, if nothing is mentioned, word size we have to take 4 bytes. Remember it. Okay, so because majority of the modern architectures have word sizes byte, I mean 4 bytes. So 4 words means what? Each word is 4 bytes, then 4 words means 16 bytes. Now try to understand. So cache size is 16 KB, I mean especially words, right? That means only data. So in 16 KB, how many, you know, words we have in each block? 4 words. That means each block is consuming 16 bytes. Let me divide that with 16 bytes. What you get? The total number of, you know, bytes are 16 KB in the entire cache, but each block contains 16 bytes. Then if you divide 16 KB by 16 B, you get number of cache blocks. Understand? Example, the total number of bytes in your cache is 32 bytes, but each block contains, let's say, 4 words. 4 words means 16 bytes, but total 32 bytes we have. Then how many blocks we will be there? For that, we have to divide by 32 bytes by 16 bytes. In the same way, whenever you want to find out from now onwards number of cache blocks for a problem, first find out the size of the cache. Okay, 16 KB. It's specially, you know, size of the data in the cache. Size of the data in the cache by total number of size of the data in the block. If you divide, then you get number of blocks. BB will be cancelled. Then 16 will be cancelled. You got K. K means 1024, right? So number of blocks finally 1024. We should remember it. So when you have 1024 blocks like this, then how to index the right block? To index the right block, then 10 bits are required, and we know that this 10 bits we are going to use, and we have seen examples for that, right? Always we, you know, take these 10 bits to decide which block our main memory address will go, right? So cache index finally size will be 10 bits, right? So the third thing is tag. Tag size is nothing but total number of bits in your main memory address, which is nothing but 32, which is given. Out of 32, remove this cache index 10 bits and word offset 2 bits. 32 minus 10, 22. 22 minus 2, 20. So tag bits are 20. In the word addressable system, number of tag bits are 20. Now we got this 20 bits, 1 bit here. And what is the size of the data in bits? I would like to find out everything in bits. Data size already we know, 16 KB overall, but each cache block size 4 words. 4 words means 16 bytes, correct? So 16 bytes. If I divided it to bits, it will be 16 into byte means 8 bits. It would be 128 bits. Now finally I got a block size 128 bits here, pure data, and tag 20 bits, one for valid bit, right? So finally 128 plus 20, 148, 148 plus 1, 149. So 149 bits are required in a block. The question is, how many total bits are required? This I can say overhead. This is original data. This is extra information we require to, I mean, correctly get the data, right? Now I can say one thing, simple. The total number of bits in your overall cache equal to how many blocks we have. How many blocks we have? Just now we have calculated, we have 1024 blocks, right? Into, in each block we have 1 valid bit, 20 tag bits, and 128 data bits. Then if you simplify it, you get 1024 into 149. Now let me solve this problem in a, you know, one more way. That means by assuming that it is byte addressable system. If it is word addressable system, this is the answer. Now let us assume this is byte addressable system. If it is byte addressable system, what are the modifications we are going to get? We will see. In byte addressable system, every byte gets, this is important because sometimes, you know, in the question they will mention that it is byte addressable system. In byte addressable system, what happens? Only the thing is addressing will be different. Every byte will have one memory address, you remember. Okay, if this is your 32 bit memory address, okay, then every byte is going to get a number, then I can say one thing. What is the size of your, you know, block, cache block? So here, cache block size is 4 words, right? Let us repeat, 4 words. 4 words means 16. Each word is 4 bytes, then 16 bytes, correct? I can say like this. So finally, you have 16 bytes in your cache block, right? Now, so to, you know, address that 16 bytes, because every byte is going to have separate number, then to differentiate that 16 bytes, we need how many bits? 4 bits, okay? The same thing I can represent like this, because it is a byte addressable system, then you will be having two further classifications. One is first word offset, which word you want, because each cache block has how many words? 4, right? So how many bits are required to decide which word it is? 2 bits. Now I want 2 more bits. Why, sir? Once I identify the word, right, I should find out the, you know, correct byte also, correct? Because it's a byte addressable system, then sometimes, you know, I should be able to find out the right byte, because any byte I can access. Then if I want to access a particular byte, then how many bits are required? Because there are 4 bytes, right? Then 2 more bits are required. So finally, if the problem is about byte addressable system, in the byte addressable system, then we have to consider bits for byte offset. This is called byte offset. Otherwise, blindly remember one thing. If the problem is about byte addressable system, what you have to do, you know, we have to take some bits for byte offset, some bits for word offset. First, I will tell you how many bits we have to take for byte offset. This would be good. Okay. Don't, you know, worry too much, because if you, what is byte offset is nothing, but in a word, how many bits are required to differentiate your byte? In a word, how many bytes we have? 4 bytes, correct? Byte 1, byte 2, byte 3, byte 4. In byte addressable system, the only thing is every byte is getting a number, right? Every byte should be differentiated. That's why we are addressing everything. That's why how many bits are required to, you know, separate these 4 bytes, to differentiate these 4 bytes? 2 bits. Using these last 2 bits, we will decide whether our, you know, byte is this one or this one. In that way, we can differentiate a particular byte. Fine. Now, in the remaining part of the main memory address, we want 2 more bits. Why, sir? Because I want to find out a particular word in a block. In a block, how many words we have? 4. To identify the right, once you come to the block, to identify the right word, then you require 2 bits. I can say 00 this one, 01 this one, 10 this one, 11. In that way, using 2 more bits, I can differentiate the word. Now see, let me summarize. Using 2 bits, I will come to the particular word. Using other 2 bits, I will come to the particular byte. So that is what the meaning of byte addressable system. So that's why 2 bits here, 2 bits here, 4 bits are required. Then how many total bits we have? 32. Out of 32 bits, 4 bits are gone. Then remaining bits are 28. Out of 28, so some bits for cache index, because it is direct mapping. So cache index field and tag field, remember it. How to decide cache index field? It depends on the number of cache blocks you have. So we have not changed number of cache blocks. So that's why 10 bits. Already we have seen that, you know, we have 1024 cache blocks. Now comes tag field. So tag is easy. 10 plus 2 plus 2, 14 bits are gone. Then remaining bits for tag. Then the solution will be, you know, 18 bits for tag. Using that, we solve this problem. So same formula, 1024 blocks. Each block has this structure, 1 bit for valid bit, and this time 18 bits for tag, right? Plus data. We have data of size, already we have seen, right? 16 into 8, 128 here, okay? If you have a doubt, just check it out. It is, you know, 4 word block size, 4 words. We have 4 words here, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 into 4, 16 bytes, correct? So 4 into 4, 16 bytes. Finally, we converted these, you know, data into bytes. To convert it into bits, that is what we are doing, because we have valid bit and tag bits, everything in bits. That's why I'm dividing it into bits. 16 bytes are, you know, if they are divided into bits, that will become 128 bits, right? 128, 146, 147. So answer is 1024 into 147. Otherwise 147 kilobits. Okay, from now onwards you remember these two techniques. If the problem is about byte addressable, we should do like this. If the problem is about word addressable system, we have to do like this. That's the difference. Okay, there is a small difference. Understand? So this is about direct mapping problem. Understand? We'll see some more direct mapping technique problems to understand the things clearly.